Thank you for joining us on Top Story Season 2. I'm Innocent Salwa. In today's show, we are bringing you one of the most successful persons in the banking industry. He has worked in the banking industry for the last 25 years and still counting. He is a businessman, an accountant, and also a banker. So today, we want to know much about this person. He has been known for transforming Equity Bank right from the time it was making a loss of 5 million shillings until now, where it's making a profit of over 10 billion shillings. I bring to you the person behind the success of Equity Bank, the Chief Executive Officer of Equity Bank, Dr. James Mwangi. Welcome to the interview. In a nutshell, who is Dr. Mwangi?
Thank you very much, Innocent. I'm an ordinary Kenyan, like any other Kenyan, born up in the slopes of the Aberdares. Grew up in Lulo setup, went to primary school, secondary school, and high school in Lulo setting. And then only managed to come to Nairobi. I was coming to Nairobi University. Since then, I've worked principally in Nairobi since graduating from the university. In between, having been born in a family, a brother, two sisters and brother, and within a family setup, relates like any other Kenyan. I'm married to Jane Njuguna, and we are blessed to have our three sons, John, Evans, and Alex. So that, in a brief, is James Mwangi, the person.
What are some of the life-changing processes that you've gone through that has made you to become what you are today?
Some of the life-changing processes that have occurred to me, one is access to education. I am a product of the education that was availed to me. Otherwise, I came from a very humble family, and I would not be here with you today if it was not for education. So I see it as the most transformative aspect or process of my life. In my working environment and interaction, I've also had the privilege of being inspired by very great people and hopefully shaping my thought process, learning from people who have accomplished and really walking in the footsteps and learning maybe from the very best. That privilege of interaction by basically being offered the opportunity to be on very senior global advisory boards has given me a unique opportunity to learn from the very best. The leadership position in Equity Bank has been also a major transformation. The opportunity to have 9,000 followers really scales my significance and impact in society because I achieve through people. The trust that has been bestowed to me by the board of Equity Bank itself is very humbling. And being given an opportunity to be chairman of Vision 2030 has not only helped me to really scale myself from an institutional framework to a national framework that can have influence to a country, and lastly, being on global boards like the African Leadership Academy, the Obama Global Development Initiative, the Bill and Melinda Gates, the Clinton Global Initiative, the UN Advisory Board. Again, that really helps me to scale my influence and impact on a global sphere.
You have worked in Equity Bank for more than 25 years. Now, one of the major programs that you've had is the Wings to Fly. Now, is this something that it came from your past or just something you thought of?
The Wings to Fly program has a lot to do with my background and understanding. I was a beneficiary of what we used to call as bursary schemes. And I could not have access to the education at Kagumo High School without the support of that program. And as I saw, I was able to close the bridge because of support of others. And my mother challenged me at a very tender age to adopt a secondary school in my village. And truly, Nyagatogo Secondary School became fully transformed from achieving a mean score of 4 to a mean score of 8.7, becoming the best district school in the country. And then she challenged me, "You've done so well for our village. A village school sending from 0 students to university to 75 students to university. Why don't you try to help orphans outside our village?" And that was the genesis of the Wings to Fly.
Maybe talking of Equity Bank, when you joined Equity Bank, so far you've transformed it from where it was until now where it is. Now, what are these unique attributes that you brought into the banking industry that changed, that transformed Equity Bank?
Thank you very much. The story of Equity Building Society today, Equity Bank, is a story of the society. We looked and asked ourselves, how can we be relevant to society? And I guess what was lacking then was relevance of banking to the community and society. There are so many barriers for society to enjoy banking services. Only 4% of Kenyan population had bank accounts. I'm glad to say today we have 85% of the population having a bank account. So we made banking relevant to society.
Now, how would you define how a person can be successful in life?
When I was very young, I was very ambitious on very basic things. The first one was to have a meal that would always have meat. But you could imagine that was a huge motivation because meat was really a scarcity. I wanted to have tea with 5 teaspoons of sugar because I never had sugar in my childhood. And those were the basic motivations and inspiration as I sought education. But I grew up, I realized that literally the issue of human needs are very, very limited. For the last 27 years, I've never tasted sugar by choice. I realized it was not good. I think for the last couple of years, I've not tasted red meat. I realized it was not really. And the question was then, what is success? Success is to be the self. And so I started defining success as to the smiles that you can put in the faces of others by availing them opportunity.
Do you have any other programs you would want to initiate or you may be having in mind?
Equity Bank has 8 thematic areas of focus in form of programs. Because Wings to Fly, we take at education, it's a question of leadership development. We take the best boy and the best girl every year once we get secondary education results, and we coach them, we mentor them as the next generation of leaders. The most impactful is agriculture, where we have 280 dedicated staff who are agroeconomists. And they don't work in the bank, they help farmers to improve their crop husbandry, their livestock skills, because we know ultimately the change of this society will only occur when we transform our agricultural practices.
There's a CV.
Agriculture must be made a high value sector because it provides livelihood to 85% of the people. So they are helping people to adopt better practices in agriculture, like adoption of certified seeds, fertilizers, appropriate chemicals, and the crop husbandry. And what we have seen is yields increasing by even up to 4 times. And once yields have increased to 4 times without corresponding increase in cost, it means the revenues of the farmers are going up 4 times.
You have received so many awards in Kenya, in Africa, and all over the world. Now, do these awards inspire you in any way?
Of course, awards and accolades and recognitions are moments of celebrating. They are moments of affirmation and endorsement by others. It's very important what you think about yourself, but it's even more important what others think about yourself. I remember in 2005, when I won the Global Vision Awards, I couldn't believe it that the world had seen an African from Kenya could be said to be the best envisioning the future. And truly, the world had seen what we had never seen, because 7 years later, in 2012, that vision of a disrupting financial system, which at the vision level was codenamed Initiator of a Concept of the Future that will change the global economy. By 2012, that concept won the Global World Entrepreneur of the Year. So you could see that affirmed and gave me confidence and trust in the self, so to the steps we are making.
Do you have any plans to join politics?
Let me say that over the last 27 years that I've worked in Equity Bank, my DNA has almost come to be synonymous with the vision of Equity Bank. And as a vision bearer, I would feel to be abandoning the cause if I was to ever change my commitment. But at a personal level, I hope I will be a better father, a better husband, a better relative to my family. And to my colleagues, I hope now I will ascend from a managerial operational leader to a coach and a mentor, so that I really can clone myself, hopefully in 100 people before the next 10 years. You can imagine if that was to have, then the impact it would have in society. That is what I think will be the next phase of my life.
Thank you. So thank you so much, Dr. Mwangi, for the interview. And thank you.
Thank you, Innocent. The insights in the questions, they seem to have really thought of which questions would bring out. So they made the interview very, very easy by having the right questions. And I hope from the brief of what they wanted to achieve, I think they were spot on.